Having to uninstall your Pro Tools SE application due to technical issues should be your last resort. Before doing so, make sure that you've watched the optimization videos in the Pro Tools Customer Success playlist on the AVID YouTube channel. These will help to get your computer in tip-top condition for using real-time music apps like Pro Tools SE. There are many videos at your disposal, both Mac and Windows 7. If after optimization and troubleshooting you still have to uninstall and reinstall Pro Tools SE, here's how to do it. Okay, first things first, please make sure that your audio interface that came with your Pro Tools SE system is unplugged. If yours is connected to your computer, then unplug it now. We'll begin by opening the control panel from the Start menu. And once you're there, we want to make changes to Programs and Features. Click on it and locate the AVID Pro Tools SE program just here. Then right-click and initiate the uninstall. Now, if your Pro Tools SE installation disk is not in your DVD reader, then you'll get this message. Just pop it into the DVD player and then dismiss the autoplay window. Then click OK and you'll be asked what kind of uninstall to perform. We'll do Pro Tools, Preferences and Database, basically everything. Once everything has been removed, choose one of the options for the restart. Now I'm going to choose to restart later and I'm going to click Finish. Now you'll notice that Pro Tools will disappear from the list. Gone. Excellent. Now I'm also going to remove the Interlok driver. Now if you have any software that uses the iLock for copy protection, then you may want to skip this step. Then finally, the audio driver for the audio interface. Now, if yours is still connected, which it shouldn't be, then you may get this warning, a warning that the M-Audio taskbar software is running. Unplug your audio interface, then click OK to continue. Now, your Pro Tools SE uninstall is complete. You'll now need to restart your computer. Now, do not connect your audio interface to the computer even once it's rebooted. Now, don't connect it until you've reinstalled Pro Tools SE and followed the installation instructions. I've even made a video for installing Pro Tools SE on a Windows system.